This was supposed to be a quick one and done print. Three prototypes later, I finally built the angle grinder holder I should have started with. Hey, I'm Sean, and I'm on a mission to organise my workshop one French cleat at a time. I design custom tool holders and share the files so you can get your space sorted too. For years, my grinders lived in a cupboard, and the discs, scattered across the workshop like confetti. Every time I need to cut something, I spend more time looking for the right disc than actually using the tool. I needed a way to keep the grinder and discs together, but I didn't want a bulky wood or metal holder you can buy off the shelf, just something clean and efficient. Sounds simple. Turns out not so much. First up was figuring out how to store the grinder and discs together. I decided to go vertical, with the discs tucked right under the grinder body. That way, they're locked in place when the grinder's mounted, and the whole thing stays compact enough to print on a standard 3D printer. Right, let's jump over to the computer and model this up. Someone asked me recently what I use for design. It's SolidWorks. Bit overkill for some stuff, but it does the job. I started by dimensioning the cup section that holds the grinder's guard, gave it a little wiggle room so it fits most models without a fuss. I'm gluing this one together. It gives a quick, solid bond. And honestly, I don't see any reason it'd need to come apart again. Works great for this kind of application. But hey, if you think metal fasteners would be better, let me know down in the comments. So here's the first design. The disc holder actually works really well. Holds up to 30 or so thin discs, no problem. The grinder sits snug in the cup, just like I hoped. Only issue, bit of an oversight, the cable. I tried wrapping it around the grinder, same way I'd been storing it before, and yeah, it looked like I'd given up halfway through. My go-to solution for this kind of thing has usually been a cable wrap on the side of the holder. Here's the one I built for my palm sander. Works a treat. Check out my other videos if you want a closer look at that one. I figured something similar could work here too. Maybe a longer cable wrap running down the side. Only issue I've had before is that winding and unwinding the cable can get fiddly once it's mounted on the cleat. But let's give it a shot and see how it holds up. Ah, 8 hours of printing, gone. Or maybe not. If you're into 3D printing, you've probably run into this before. Here's a handy trick to save a failed print. Measure the height where it stopped, slice the model at that point, and start the print from there. Takes a bit of glue up afterward, but still way quicker than printing the whole thing again. So here's my second attempt. I trimmed the back of the cable wrap to let the cord slide in and out more easily, and it actually worked better than I expected. Only downside, it still sticks out more than I'd like. Then I had an idea. What if the cable wrapped around the entire holder instead? That way, I could mount it right next to other cleats without needing space on the side to unwind the cable. Let's get it printed and see if it works. Okay, so here's the final design. I wasn't sure I'd be able to get the grinder out with the cable wrapped around the holder, but it actually works just fine. It definitely cuts down on the space needed for the cable and makes winding and unwinding way easier. But I'm still curious. What do you think? Which version would you prefer? Drop your thoughts in the comments. If you fancy printing one of these for your own workshop, check below for links to the files. Feel free to tweak them to suit your setup. And if you're into workshop organisation, I've got plenty more French cleat builds and tool holders on the channel. Go have a browse and see what sparks an idea.